Hi, I'm Brian Cottle. I'm a postdoc on the AQMed team at SandboxAQ, and I work on biomedical engineering and artificial intelligence and signal processing. I'm here with Simon.
Hello, I'm Simon Tam. I'm a postdoctoral fellow in the AQMed team as well. Background in signal processing and AI, and I'm working mostly on denoising and processing the data from our unshielded MCG device. All right, Brian. So I guess today we're going to talk about what makes our challenges or solutions unique in the market. And I think one big component of it is that we're building a unshielded MCG device. Whereas in the market, there are existing devices. What the other companies do is shielded MCG. So these big bulky devices already come with pretty clean signals out of the box. Whereas ourself, to bring more value to the market, we're hoping to build a unshielded device, which brings its whole load of new challenges because the signals we're looking for are really a million times smaller, if not more, than the environmental magnetic noise. So how creative do we have to be to tackle this challenge?
Yeah, and the answer is extremely creative, very clever, but also within the bounds of like really understanding our problem, understanding the biology as well, and understanding the physics behind it. And this problem is so difficult because an example that we like to use, which you're very well aware of, is that it's sort of like having a conversation at a cocktail party. And you're trying to understand what somebody, maybe further away is saying, or maybe across the room. But what you, in addition to just having it be a really noisy environment, this cocktail party is also happening right next to a functioning and running jet engine, which is like us trying to measure the minute and tiny magnetic fields of the heart in the presence of all of the magnetic noise that's going on around us, and the Earth's magnetic field. That's orders of magnitude, the noise is orders of magnitude larger. And so there's a few different ways that we can use to explore and remove the noise from these signals. There can be what we may call deterministic methods, which are more classical. These are methods that have been tried and true, that are sort of could be considered linear, that when you have an input come in, you understand the way that things come out the other end. But there may be more advanced methods or more modern methods using machine learning, like large models. And could you tell me more about those?
Yeah, I mean, I think one big trade-off is the assumptions we need to make about the signal. I think the imagery of the cocktail party is good as far as the scale of the noise. Somebody talking to you, maybe at this distance in front of a jet engine, big, many orders of magnitude of difference, but also the speciality of it. If you're, like you mentioned, if you're trying to hear somebody across a room, you need to use your two ears to parse information from the room and know that, oh, this person that I'm trying to listen to is right there, but there's somebody right next to you that's shouting to somebody else in the room. So either you have access to the signals to locate the signals in space, as you can do with signal space separation with your two ears, you can locate somebody in a room. But it's often hard when you're in a real clinical environment in a hospital. You don't know where the instruments are. You don't know where the elevator is in the building, but the elevator will affect your signals. Cars driving down the streets, they will affect it, but you don't know that information. And I think the most powerful methods you mentioned, like something leveraging machine learning, deep learning, need very rich data set where you need to cover as much ground as possible. So it's a big trade-off, especially if you're going into a very sensitive problem, medical diagnostics.
Yeah, and I think you touched on something really important there, is that this is a really sensitive and kind of a crucial field to get it right. In medical diagnosis, you want to know that you're doing it correctly. And especially with reconstructing your signal or extracting your signal from the noise, you need to really understand what your signal is going to look like. Then you're talking about like these models, having a proper model. Because in many circumstances, especially in ours, measuring these magnetic fields, there's noise that perfectly overlaps with our signal, and they're like right on top of each other. And so we really need to understand what's happening in the heart. We need to be able to understand very precisely so that we can extract that from the enormous amount of noise around us. And that's where some of these methods come into play. Then, you know, in machine learning, there are, you may have heard of, you know, we talk about diffusion models or other methods to remove noise. And they have their pros and cons. And so another aspect of this that's difficult is because, you know, we may be able to use a machine learning model, and that's extraordinarily powerful, but how do we know how well it will behave in environments where it hasn't been exposed to before? You know, think about, you know, other maybe more models that people are more have more experience with or interacting with, like ChatGPT. We're discovering now that it's in the wild, people are interacting with it more, that it behaves maybe a little bit quirky in some circumstances. Mm. We want to make sure that as we're building our models, as we're removing noise from our data, that we're getting it right, and that it will behave predictably and appropriately under all the circumstances that it will encounter.
Mm-hmm. No, yeah, absolutely. This is very critical for a medical device. You know, there's the consequences for even the slightest errors are just too large.
So thank you for watching, and make sure you subscribe to our Sandbox AQ YouTube channel.